Dear students, good morning. As we are passing through corona pandemic, it is necessary to keep in touch with our course structure on history subject. So let's start the topic, the Kushana Empire and the rule of Kanishka. Well, as you know, from the time of Alexander's invasion, the lands outside the northwest frontiers of India became a political playground of the Greek powers. The Central Asian lands saw extensive movements of different races of people. These races destroyed the Greek supremacy in those regions and turned to be a new source of danger to the northwest of India. These people were nomadic and were in search of new homes. They were fighting among themselves for territorial gains and political powers. It was in that kind of racial migration and contest for lands that the Kushanas rose to power in Central Asia. The Kushanas are considered to be one of the five branches of the Yuezhi tribe who lived in the Chinese frontier or Central Asia. They are known as Guizhuang in Chinese sources. A few years after the downfall of the Mauryan Empire, the Kushanas moved eastward towards India, defeating the Parthians and the Sakas in the 1st century AD and went on to create a big empire in modern-day Afghanistan, Pakistan and northern parts of India. In the opening year of the 1st century, Kujala Kadphises was the first Yuezhi chief to lay the foundation of the Kushana Empire in India and established his supremacy over other Yuezhi tribes and became their overlord. The first ruler of the Kushana dynasty was also known as Kadphises I. He ruled over a part of Afghanistan and occupied Hindu Kush extending from Parthia to Indus and had also issued coins in his name. The Kushana kingdom under this king rose into prominence rapidly. His kingdom included the territories formerly ruled by the Greeks, the Sakas and the Parthians. Kujala Kadphises was succeeded by his son Bhima Takto, known as the Nameless King. Since his coins only showed the legend, the King of Kings, Great Savior, who in turn was succeeded by Uimo Kadphises or Bhima Kadphises and ruled this vast territory till his death. He is regarded as the real builder of the Kushana Empire in India. This phase is known as Kadphises II. He had issued both gold and copper coins, inscriptions on coin proclaiming himself as a Shiva devotee and as the ruler of whole world. Maharaja, Rajadhiraja, Sarvalokeshwara and Maheshwara indicate his embracing Hindutva. A large number of Roman gold coins found from this era also indicate the prosperity of India at that time and also the growing trade with the Romans. Bhima Kadphises or Kadphises II was succeeded by Kanishka as the third king of the Kushana dynasty. His exact relation with Kadphises II is not known, but his immediate succession to the throne after him proves that he was the next in line to rule over the empire. Now we shall discuss about Kanishka's reign. Kanishka was the great emperor of Kushana dynasty and also a great king of ancient India. He combined in himself the military talent of Chandragupta Maurya and the spiritual thought of Ashoka. So he is famous for his military, political and spiritual achievements. Okay? So there is no unanimity in regarding his date of accession. The exact date of Kanishka's reign still remains controversial, but with the accession to throne, there began the Shaka era or the Shakabda in Indian history. The year 78 AD has been accepted by most historians as the year of the foundation of the Shaka era. The view of Ferguson, Adi Banerjee, Robson, Dr. Rai Choudhury, and many other scholars is that Kanishka was founder of Shaka era and consequently ascended throne in 78 AD. It appears paradoxical that though Kanishka was a Kushana emperor and not a Shaka, yet the era founded by him became famous as the Shaka era. This was for the fact that to the Indian people of that time, the Shakas and the Kushanas appeared as the same type of external tribes to pass under a common name as Shaka. Since the Shakas came and settled earlier and also became Indianized before the Kushana, as their name became more familiar to the Indians. So, Kanishka was one of the greatest rulers of ancient India. By his conquest, by religious activities, and by patronizing the Indian culture, he made the Kushana period very eminent and distinguished. Let's start the conquest of Kanishka. Kanishka extended the Kushana Empire vastly, both outside and inside India. At the time of his accession to the throne, the Kushana Empire included Afghanistan, part of Sindh, the Punjab portions of Parthia and Bactria. Kanishka added many territories to his kingdom by his annexations. It is obvious that he fought a series of battles during his reign and established his capital at Purushappura, Peshawar. Inside India, he conquered Kashmir in the early part of his reign. Kanishka built many monasteries, chaityas, and other monuments in the Kashmir Valley. He founded the city Kanishkapura in Kashmir, which place is still known as Kanishpur, situated near Barmula. Kanishka conquered many interior parts of the Gangetic Valley and occupied Magadha. It is mentioned in the Buddhist literature that after the capture of Pataliputra, he brought the famous Buddhist philosopher Asogyasa with him to his capital. So he also established his supremacy over other areas of the north like Oudh, Banaras, Shravasti, Gorakhpur, and Mathura. Kanishka fought against some of the Shaka satrapas who were still ruling over Western India. So he defeated the Shaka ruler of Ujjaini and extended his authority to Malwa. He humbled the Parthians on the west. He also led an army across the Pamirs to subdue the petty nomads, chiefs of Khotan, Arkan, and Kashgar. And outside India, Kanishka fought against and defeated the kings of the Parthians and annexed his territories to his empire. Thereafter, he crossed the Pamirs with his army and invaded Khotan, Arkand, and Kashgar. The rulers of these territories having been subordinate chiefs under the Chinese emperor. So Kanishka had to fight against the Chinese emperor and ultimately came out victorious over the Chinese and established his sovereignty over Khotan, Arkand, and Kashgar. Thus, Kanishka ruled a vast empire that included Afghanistan, Bactria, Kashgar, Khotan, and Arkand, and Kashmir. Sindh, the Punjab, United Provinces, and a portion of Malwa are also parts of his territorial position. Next, we shall discuss about the administration of Kanishka. Very little is known about the administration and the style of functioning of Kanishka's government. From the Saranath inscription, it is learned that he divided his vast empire into several provinces and put them under the charge of Kshetrapas or governors. These officials were carefully selected and were not allowed to revolt against the central authority. Utmost attention was paid for the maintenance of law and order in the empire. If anybody tried to revolt against the authority of the king, he was dealt ruthlessly पुरुषपुर द कैपिटल सिटी वाज वन ऑफ द ब्यूटीफुल सिटीज ऑफ इंडिया। इट वाज अडॉर्न्ड विथ मेनी नोबल एडिफिसेस, लफ्टी ऑफ बिल्डिंग्स एंड मोनुमेंट्स एंड बुद्धिस्ट मोनास्ट्रीज। देर आर एविडेंसेस टू शो दैट कनिष्क हैज मेड इट ए ग्रेट सिटी एज ए पॉलिटिकल सेंटर, ए मिलिटरी स्ट्रांग होल्ड एंड ए सेक्रेड प्लेस ऑफ बुद्धिज्म। पुरुषपुर अटेंड द स्टेटस ऑफ अदर नोटेबल एंशियंट कैपिटल्स लाइक पाटलिपुत्र। रिसेंट आर्कियोलॉजिकल डिस्कवरीज शो दैट दिस फेमस सिटी ऑफ कनिष्क वॉज सिचुएटेड नियर द मॉडर्न कैपिटल ऑफ द नॉर्थ वेस्ट फ्रंटियर्स प्रोविंस पेशवर। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन द नेक्स्ट पार्ट वी शाल डिस्कस अबाउट द रिमेन पोर्शंस ऑफ एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ कनिष्क। ओके, थैंक यू। Have a good day.